What is the best way to celebrate Milad? The Sunnah way. Subhanallah. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Somebody asked me how to celebrate a Milad in a Sunnah way. If you want to celebrate in the Sunnah way, so I would ask you, go adopt a life of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and that the way we celebrate the Milad every single day. And you want to celebrate a Milad, you fast on Monday. You want to celebrate a Milad, then stop what the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said to stop. You want to celebrate Milad every day, you live a life 24 hours according to the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, that is celebrating the Milad every single day. You don't need to wait for next year, or you don't have to wait for the 12th Rabiul Awwal or anything. First of all, the Milad does not exist anywhere. It does not, it was not there for 600 years after the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. For 600 years, it was not there. This was being started by the Shi'i groups, which was called Fatimid. Fatimid dynasty was being called because these people was they claimed to be the descendants from the Fatima radiallahu anhu, and they were the one who was being claimed to be the descendants from the same lineage coming to the front, and these were the Shi'i people. And this Shi'i group was among the Shi'i groups. They started this monopoly in the Egypt. After 600 years, there was no concept of a Milad or the Nasheed or the Mahfil or anything like that. And basically, this was the way of Shaitan, who distracted the Muslim Ummah to remove them from the Sunnah way into the Bid'ah way. So there is no way, the concept of Milad does not exist. It's a Maulad or Miladun Nabi or whatever you call it. There is no such a Sunnah way to celebrate that. If you really love the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, adopt a life of 24 hours. Not just wait for Rabiul Awwal, or not just wait for the 12th Rabiul Awwal. You want to love Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, you want to obey Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, because it says in Surah Ahzab, verse number 70-71, where the Prophet, where Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala said, "Ya ayyuhallazina amanu taqullaha wa qulu qawlan sadida yuslih lakum amalakum wa yaghfir lakum dhunubakum wa man yut'illaha wa rasulahu faqad faza fawzan azima." If you want to look into get a falah in the dunya and akhirah, you need to get a success in the dunya or akhirah. So you have to obey Allah and you have to obey the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. But you cannot just like set up something, your own desires and calling, justifying. You justifying your own self. I'm going to do that, which is going to be pleasing Allah. It will please the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. It is pleasing no one but a shaitan. It is pleasing Iblis, but no one else. If you want to please Allah, if you want to please the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Allah has said in the Quran, obey Allah, ati Allah, ati Rasul. That's a way you get a falah in dunya and akhirah, and that's a sunnah way you adopt in your life every day. Not just like in every one year, after 1 year or 12th Rabiul Awwal or the Rabiul Awwal complete entire month. You don't have to wait for that. You can celebrate every single day Milad by adopting the life of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Then you have to fast on Monday. This is the way you do that. You have to stay away from what is haram, and you have to adopt what is permissible and stay in the limit and do not go beyond the limit, and that is the way you celebrate the Milad every day.